Hey everybody, I'm going to make a recipe today and it's called guacamole, but it's got a little bit of a twist to it. So if you guys like guacamole or avocados, I think you're really going to like this. And even if you don't like it, watch it, all right? Because come on, I'm making a video for you guys. The weird thing is the grocery store around here had avocados on sale. And yeah, it's really cool because I love avocados. Turns out avocados are good for you. They're not bad for you. They're actually really good for you. And they had them on sale for 50 cents a piece. I know, 50 cents a piece. How can you say no? And so look at how many I got. Go into the store and you just squeeze it lightly. Not heavily, but if it has a little bit of give, just a little bit of give, it's perfect. Because you just set these on the counter and they'll continue to ripen. So if it's a little bit hard, don't worry about it. But what you don't want is something super squishy. You don't want that. That's too thin. But I put my avocados on the counter. These are still hard, all of these. So these are going to last quite a while. I got another week or so left on these. I have three of them that are ready to go. So I'm going to make some dip. And I'm going to show you how I do it. It's really cool. And I'm going to make my own homemade chips with this. And most people have guacamole with like Doritos or chips in a bag and stuff. I'm actually going to make the chips. And I'm going to show you how it's done. It's a little bit of a twist too. I don't know why, but I guess I do things a little bit different than everybody else because I can. But anyway, I'm going to make chips different than you've seen probably made by most people, and guacamole made different than you've seen by most people, and it's actually going to be really good, too. All right, let's get started. I'm going to try not to, well, I was going to try not to talk so much, but that doesn't work, does it? Okay, let's go. Okay, for the onion, I use about a half. You just want to dice it up really, really small. Everything in the guacamole should be very finely diced. You don't want any large chunks. Okay, for the avocados, the easiest way I've found to do these, and you know me, I'm all into the easiest way to do just about anything. Slice from top to bottom, all the way around. Do a little bit of a turn. Hold on to it. Hit it with the knife. Spin. It comes out. Toss this in the trash. You know, you can grow the avocado seeds. I just don't want to grow one yet. I will be growing one later this year. And I don't take a spoon and scoop it out. That just takes too long. I found an easy way to do this. When you do about like 50 avocados a day in a restaurant, you find the easiest way to do it. I take it, squeeze it in half. What that will do is just squeeze the inside out. Voila. I cleaned it out almost instantly. Okay, once you get your avocado and onion in there, it's really easy. As for three avocados, this is going to be enough dip for, you know, four people easily. Three avocados, you want to use about maybe a teaspoon of pepper, about a half a teaspoon of pepper, okay? I just sprinkle it in. About a half a teaspoon of pepper. Garlic. I'd say about a quarter of a teaspoon. Let's make it a half. You never have too much garlic. The thing about avocados is they're like a sponge. They soak up flavor of other spices. Seasoning salt is wonderful stuff. I'd say about a quarter teaspoon of that. Cumin. Same. Let's make it easy. Quarter teaspoon of everything. How's that sound? Tabasco. About maybe 2 to 3 drops. That's it. Now, here comes a special ingredient. All right, do not shoot me. This really works. It's mayonnaise. Not Miracle Whip, mayonnaise. I don't even want to get into Miracle Whip, all right? With you want to put in about maybe 1 heaping tablespoon. A very heaping tablespoon. Okay, you may think, mayonnaise? That's disgusting. Who would put mayonnaise in this? Trust me. What it is when you make guacamole, it's going to be kind of rich. And what the mayonnaise does is it smooths out the texture and it evens out the taste. And it's fantastic. Just try it. I mean, just try it one time. Tell me it isn't good. Seriously, try it. Tell me you didn't like it. You can't even taste the mayonnaise. Now what I do is I just hit it with a fork. I don't throw it in a blender. I don't do any kind of weird stuff to it. And you just beat it up with a fork. You want to add everything first and then beat it up. That way you're mixing it as you smash it, and you don't want to turn it into a pulp, that you don't want any large chunks in there. Little chunks are okay. Just hit it a few times, go around it with a fork. Now you can squeeze in a half a lemon, half a lime. That's perfect. I mean, you can do that. I choose to use fruit fresh. I know. But it's not like some kind of strange MSG or anything. What this does is it keeps it from oxidizing. I just sprinkle in about a fourth of a teaspoon. It has absolutely no flavor. And you use it like when you're processing fruits and things like that. It keeps them from turning brown. It's just basically ascorbic acid. To store it, and just throw a piece of plastic over to keep the air out, and then toss the lid on. That makes it even more airtight than just the lid. And then just throw it in the fridge and you're set to go. All I do is cut them like that. Put them together. Cut them like that. And cut them like that. And voila. Now, as far as cooking them, that's a breeze. Anyway, we got our pan. I don't like to use a wide pan because when you have to dump in a lot more oil. I like to use a smaller one so the oil is a lot deeper. And I recommend using corn oil. A lot of people will use shortening, but shortening is generally made out of soybean oil. And I'm really not too fond of cooking my chips in soybean oil. I mean, I have nothing against soybeans. Soybean oil, no. I use corn oil, and it gives them a really good flavor. Just get a big bottle of corn oil, heat it up to medium high, toss these in. I don't toss them all in at once. I like to get them layered in there so they get in the oil. And they're going to cook relatively quick, too. Anyway, you just toss them in there. They'll be bubbling up. Heat should be about medium high. Don't worry about burning them. They don't burn very easily. Keep pushing them down into the oil and flipping them over. I have a bowl right off to the side, and it's just got a few paper towels in it. Scoop up the chips. Let them drain for just a second or so. Tilt them a little bit. And then just throw them in the bowl. And start another batch. Okay. Here's where I go for presentation. I just finely shredded up some romaine lettuce, toss it in a bowl, that just forms the base for it because I don't want just dip, I want a little bit something extra. Okay, then we take the guacamole. Now this is going to be for like, I don't know, a couple people, all right? Spread that out just a little bit. Let's do some more. Like I said, I like big food. Then we take the chips. Just put them point side down at a slight angle. And you're all set to go. Now, if you want something a little bit different on this, I mean, come on, sour cream goes with everything. You know, if you've got some fresh cilantro, take about maybe, I'd say, a couple tablespoons of it and dice that up really fine and mix that in with the guacamole too. Cilantro, fresh cilantro, adds an amazing flavor to it. I didn't do that, so I'll do the next best thing. I'm just going to mince it up straight out of the pot. I mean, how fresh can you get? I mean, it's growing. And I'm going to sprinkle that all over. And that way they get a little bit with each chip. And these chips, they're crunchy on the outside and soft on the inside. It's a whole different texture than using corn tortillas. Okay, me and Mr. Cilantro got to go, all right? I'll talk to you later. Bye. I should be fat. Oh crap, that's not off.